Good morning, and welcome to Wesley. A special welcome to those who are worshiping with us remotely, and with B.J. Axtell and his wife, who B.J. will be delivering the morning message. Next Sunday, October the 6th, we will once again have one service at 9:30. This will be our fall kickoff Sunday with a meal in the Family Life Center afterwards. Those attending the meal are asked to bring a side dish and dessert, or dessert. Sandwiches and tableware will be provided. The annual crop walk will be at 2 that afternoon at Riverside Park with an animal blessing service held at Discovery Park at 3, a busy but fun day. The vote for one service will be Thursday, October the 17th at 6 p.m. at Wesley. If you need to vote early, there are yes, no ballots by the office door in the chapel entrance and a box to put them in. You must sign your name in order for your vote to be counted. These need to be done before October 17th at 6 p.m. Are there any other announcements that need to be made? Okay, how about joys and concerns? If you'll stand, if you have a joy and concern, then Austin will bring the mic to you. One up here.
I just wanted to say my grandson Gavin graduated from his basic training, and he said it was like summer camp. So all the prayers worked, so he said it wasn't even hard.
Congratulations. Any other? I think Austin would like some business. Okay, continued prayers for Stephanie LoBianco on the death of her husband, Sal. And also, we have many people in our congregation that are being caregivers to their spouses or to their parents, and we will pray for them.
I have a joy. I'd like to thank Austin for all he does for our church. He helps light the candles, he works on the soundboard, he helps collect with our offering. He does lots of hidden things. He sings in the children's choir. He does so many different things around this church, a lot of them known and unknown. He's a real blessing to our church family. And every time you see him do something, I request that you go up and thank him, because he really is a blessing. Austin, thank you so much.
Austin?
Thank you, Senor. I'd like to read something that we wrote, us, as in up above, and my family. Sometimes I wish I could be just that one teardrop that slides down your cheek, so I can feel your joy for me and my family, and how much you love me and are proud of me and my family. Even when I don't follow all your plans, remember, I'm human and earning my wings along the way. Thank you, Majesty.
Amen. Heavenly Father, we come to you today. We ask that you be with us. Be with us during this service. Be with us throughout the week ahead. We just thank you for our lives. We thank you for our good health. We thank you for Austin, dear Lord. He's an inspiration to each of us as we watch him throughout the week. We are so thankful that Gavin was able to get through basic training without any accidents with you by his side. Dear Lord, our country is quite a mess from the hurricane, and we just pray that you be with those families. We pray that you keep them from sickness that will spread because of the heat and the water, and we just ask that you guide each of them and each of us in rebuilding. We thank you for Fernando. We thank you for the sharing that he does of his faith so that each of us can grow a little stronger. Heavenly Father, we ask that you be with us as we pray that Jesus taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, thank you.
may be seated.
Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to sing.
have a stand and pass the keys to those.
All right, if the children will come forward. If the children will come forward, we will have children's moments.
Got it. Morning, guys. Amber, how are you? Good to see you. This our crew? Awesome. All right. How was your summer?
Good.
Good. Are we back at school? Are we in school yet? Nice. That's a big year. You like it? What do you like better? Summer or school? Staying home with mom? Summer. Yeah. A lot of times that's more fun. We get to kind of do what we want, be at our own house, all that good stuff, right? What other fun stuff did you do in the summer? Excellent, that's great. Riding bikes? You ride bikes yet?
Ride bikes.
What do you like to do a lot?
Nice. What's your favorite one? Nice, that's a great sport. Yep, that's one of my favorites too. But it's good to get out of the home, right? It's good to get out and experience stuff and have fun, right? You know, this church is kind of your home too, right?
Yeah.
Yep, this church, this is kind of your church family, right? And when we leave this home, what does God call us to do? He wants us to share Him when we go out and explore and experience life, right? Yes, yes, for sure. Do you think you can do that? Yes, for sure. Awesome. Can you pray with me? All right. You just repeat after me. How's that? Good morning, God.
Good morning.
We love our church family.
We love our church family.
We love our church home.
We love our church home.
But we know that we can't just stay here.
But we know that we can't just stay here.
Help us to leave here each time.
Help us to leave here each time.
With you in our minds and our... Sorry, I'll do it again. With you in our minds and our hearts. Amen.
Amen.
Awesome. You can go sit down. Thanks for coming up. Oh, shoot. I forgot suckers. Gosh, dang, I knew it. Oh.
I take my trust, how sweet.
If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, let Israel now say.
If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, when the foes rose up against us, then they would have swallowed us up alive, when their anger was sealed against us.
Then the flood would have swept us away. The torrent would have gone over us.
Then the raging waters would have gone over us.
Blessed be the Lord, who has not given us as prey to their teeth.
We have escaped as a bird from the snare of fowls.
The snare is broken, and we have escaped.
Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
Good morning. Our scripture today comes from Psalm 19, 7 through 14. The law of the Lord is perfect, reviving the soul. The decrees of the Lord are sure, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eyes. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinance of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. More to be desired than they are gold, even much fine gold. Sweeter also than honey and drippings of the honeycomb. Moreover, by them is your servant warned, in keeping them there is great reward. But who can detect their errors? Clear me from hidden faults. Keep back your servant also from the insolent. Do not let them have dominion over me. Then I shall be blameless and innocent of great transgression. Good morning again. So, I'm BJ. I'm glad to be here. I'm really excited this morning. I was here earlier in the summer, so I've kind of know some familiar faces here and there. I was up early this morning. It's been a great weekend. Taking my sons hunting a little bit. We've had some success. It's been a fun weekend. So I'm not sure if I've got a little bit of the Holy Spirit or a lot of caffeine in me, but we're doing good. I thought today I would introduce you to my tribe, my group of people in my life who have just had an amazingly positive effect on it. I would have to start with my best friend and wife, Joes. She's amazing. We met 20 years ago through a friendship I had with her brother. We rode the same bus all through school, but we really never knew each other until later after our school years. She's great. She's one of the most fun people I've ever met. She's funny, she laughs a lot, she loves to cut up and have a good time. She takes care of everything at our house. All the behind-the-scenes stuff, from dirty sports uniforms, yard work, driving nonstop after work, to shuffling kids around. We do share this task, but she manages it. She holds the calendar. I come down every morning, I report to duty. She tells me where I need to go, when I need to be there, who I'm picking up. Yes, drill sergeant, I'm on my way. One of my favorite ways to drink coffee on the weekends with my wife, and I use it, it's Ephesians 5:22. She loves this, by the way. Wives, be subject to your husband as you are to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife. To me, I always remind her, honey, this means you're going to have to stay back. I'm going to go get the golf club shined up. I'm heading out. You got to hang back and do some work. She's understanding, very supportive of each and every idea I have. She may not understand it, but she has my back. I think it was my midlife number two or three, midlife crisis number two or three, I can't remember which, it's been a lot, but I decided to open a second business a few years ago, already complicating our more than insane life, you know, just running around and busy. She helped me every step of the way, no complaints, just support. She's by far my favorite human, and I thank God that He brought us together. I would really like to introduce you to her sometime. Next on the list would be UB, aka Uncle Buddy. Uncle Buddy is 87 years old. He lives in Edina, Missouri. He has the heart of a 20-year-old, the spirit of one. He does not have the body anymore, so he can't move as well as he once did. When I introduce people to him, I use this. I say, if you think I'm a redneck, you should meet my uncle. He loves to catch fish. He loves to hunt turkeys. He loves the outdoors, and he loves Jesus. About 15 years ago, he invited me to go hand fishing for catfish. I wanted to do it. I had some reservations. Hand fishing is where you stick your hand into a hole underwater, hope that a catfish bites it, and you pull it out. When I asked him, I said, well, what happens if there's a snapping turtle in that hole? He didn't smile, nothing. He said, well, a snapping turtle you don't have to worry about. It'll just nip underwater. A beaver, that'll tear your arm off. Whew, that gave me no help. We did it. We didn't have any luck hand fishing that day, but we caught fish in many, you know, in another way. But it was altogether a great day. My Uncle Buddy's dressed in his Sunday best. He wears this every day of his life. Cowboy boots, Wrangler jeans, pearl button-up collared shirt, with his belly on the bottom of the river searching for catfish. It doesn't matter. He's so much fun. He's funny. He loves to joke. He loves to jab, and he takes it just as well. We were at a fish fry one time, and he fed my wife Rocky Mountain oysters after telling them they were chicken. She loved them until she found out what it was. He's hilarious. He loves God. He loves people. My buddy Cody, he's my right-hand man. We've known each other since birth. If you know him, you'll know it's him because he never stops talking. He's knowledgeable, experienced, and he has stories upon stories upon stories upon stories upon stories. He's always up for anything, whether it's going out for wild adventures to just helping me with a project. We have a lot of fun together for sure. My other friend Josh, he's the smartest guy I know. No college education, he's just smart. We have a running joke when we get stumped on pretty much anything. Call Josh, he'll figure it out. And he does. This group of friends of mine come from a generation of, if you provide cold drinks and maybe some food, we can pretty much build just about anything. It's pretty remarkable. My next friend, his name's Jesus. Now, this is an amazing guy. They wrote a book about him. Not just any book, the best-selling book of all time. Over 5 billion copies sold. My friend healed a blind guy. He rose a man from the dead. He's caring for all. He went a long ways out of his way to meet a woman at a well and comfort her. He is forgiving. In fact, he is full of forgiveness. He's taken a human like me and led me through dark times, difficult times, and brought it to light. He will give everyone a chance, and then another, and then another. He knows the best fishing spots. Don't fish over there. Throw your net over there. I like him. He woke Peter up and told him, arise, hunt, eat. He gave us animals, including ducks, my favorite. He once fed 5,000 people with 5 loaves of bread. He's awesome. My friend is brave. Facing death, he stayed strong. Through beatings, torture, humiliation, and being hung on a cross with nails, he not only held on to his beliefs, but forgave those who did this to him. Remarkable. My friend Jesus conquered death, came back to life, and promised everybody an eternal life with him. I could go on for hours and hours about Jesus and his amazing stories. I hope you know my friend, and I hope you introduce him to others. Amen.
The ushers will now pass the plates.
Salvation comes from only you.
our shelter and strength through all ages past. Your awesome power has been seen. The nations are searching for something that's absolutely true. So now we now declare it, Jesus, all truth is found in you. There is a rock, a solid rock, a rock we build our lives upon. There is a hope, a blessed hope, so we now shout it to the world. Rejected by men, but chosen by God, you are the precious cornerstone. You're building your church throughout all the earth. Forever His power will be shown. The nations are searching for something that's absolutely true. Now we'll declare it. Jesus, all truth is found in you. There is a rock, a solid rock, a rock we build our lives upon. There is a hope, a blessed hope, so we now shout it to the world. There is a rock, a solid rock, a rock we build our lives upon. There is a hope, a blessed hope, so we now shout it to the world.
Allow yourself to follow the joy of the Holy Spirit. Share that feeling by your words and actions. Take Him with you in every situation and put Him in the driver's seat. Amen.